You are listening to the latest edition of the Montage Film Review Sunday DVD Rental Suggestion Podcast. This is a masterpiece edition. The film that I want you to tell you about today is called Less Than Zero. It's a film from the 80s, starring Robert Downey Jr. as Julian, Jami Gertz as Blair, and Andrew McCarthy as Clay. Clay, Blair, and Julian are high school friends who've known each other since they were infants. They've just graduated, and Clay and Blair are making plans to go off to university. And Julian, who is a bit of a wild child and not really interested in academic achievement, has been given some money by his father to start a record label. All three of these teenagers come from very affluent families who are able to help and support them. Anyway, fast forward a few months and Clay is returning home from university by himself because Blair decided at the last minute that she didn't want to go. I think because was maybe a bit frightened of what the future might hold for her, she decides to stay at home and concentrate on a modelling career that had previously been just a hobby. Julian's record company hasn't really gotten off the ground, and he is spiralling out of control with his drug habit and his debts. In fact, he owes quite a lot of money to the local drug dealer, who is also somebody they've known since way back when, since they were prepubescent. Anyway, this isn't the first time that Clay has been home since he left for college. The last time he came home, he found his two best friends in bed together. And he's returned home this time because Blair has called him and he hopes for some kind of reconciliation with her now that he's gotten over the pain and anger. The only thing is she's invited him back home in order to help her handle Julian and his drug problem. He has a drug problem of her own that she doesn't really acknowledge, but Clay notices it and is more interested in helping her with her drug problem than Julian with his. Everybody except Clay seems to be in a really bad way. Cocaine use is very common amongst their friends, and it just seems to be a hedonistic lifestyle for everybody that they know. Parties, lots of drugs, supposedly lots of sex that usually goes in with this kind of thing, and quite frankly, parents who couldn't really give a shit about them, or parents who they have no connection with, so they don't really know each other. So they're unable to go to their parents with their issues, with their fears, with their problems. Julian has been kicked out by his father, so he's now sleeping on people's couches over at Blair's house, you know, wherever he can lie down flat, I suppose, and is hitting up his uncle for cash to open a club. That too falls through, and he finds that he's got no way to pay back his drug debts. And when have you ever heard of an understanding drug dealer? This film caused a huge stir in its day, because it was a film about the destructiveness of drugs, and there wasn't really a black person in sight. These are all white, rich kids who should know better, or at least that was the ethos behind the outrage back in the day. But if you decide to rent this movie, as I'm suggesting, or even buy the DVD, when you watch it, don't forget that this is also a very touching film about friendship. And a window into the lives of teenagers who, from a distance, would seem to have the perfect lives. I watched this movie again within the last week, and I decided to make it a masterpiece edition because even after all this time, this is still a good movie. It ages well. And I would be happy to sit and watch it again. This story has been adapted for film. Less Than Zero is the debut novel of Bret Easton Ellis, and it was published in 1985 when he was 25. He's written several other novels that have made it to the big screen, such as The Rules of Attraction, Luna Park, and American Psycho. And remember, here at Montage, we encourage you to read the book as well as watch the film. I'm your host, Shay Trinity. And as always, this has been an Eskimo Fin production.